I'm Mike Kirby. I got to play in the snare line when I was 16 at the Crossmen in 1998. And then I was next to center at Blue Knights in 2000 in the snare line. I got to go to Syracuse Brigadiers and play some senior corps, all-age corps in 2002, win high percussion with them, and then a stint at the Bushwackers. Those three latter teams, the occasion was the phone ringing, and I was there to answer it. And I was very fortunate to do so. I'd actually filled out the paperwork when I was 20 years old to go and fight forest fires in the mountains. And I was taking my paperwork to the mailbox when my cell phone rang, and it was friends saying, "You have to come join us." So phone rang on a Wednesday. The beats in the book, the exercise package, were facsimile to me on Thursday. I would learn the beats on a bus or a train or a plane on Friday and get up to the camp and rehearse all that material with the line and then perform with those groups through the rest of the season. And there was some decent successes that we obtained, and definitely some very fun books and very technical books, and taking the approach to those books that I had learned prior, playing for Tom Hannum and Colin McNutt and Nick Angelus and others, really served me well, and that was based on hard work early on. Rudiments are the basics. They're the building blocks. They are the simplest patterns that your hands are going to play in conjunction with each other, starting from stick control, through so much of the other classical and contemporary literature that we see. But fundamentals have been lost, and there are rudiments in the vocabulary that we see less of. While certainly there are other more exciting combinations that players are coming up with and writers are willing to include in their books or their the drumline's presentations. But the idea that I wanted to play with quality at all times, rhythmically, just simple sound quality, and that school of thought that I was brought up in, and applying that to everything else, my goal was never the best stick flips. It was the most even, the most sonoric, and full rudiments, paradiddles, whatever you like. So we must not lose sight of what rudiments are, and that they need be played 20 times in a row, slow to fast. If you would only write a list of your goals and repeat them 5 times in the morning, in the evening, and work hard to attain them in the waking world, that you would. But let's not dilute great sound quality and rhythmic interpretation with so much of the embellishments, because they're no more than that. So right around July of 2000, I got up the guts to decide I wanted to do a snare drum solo in DCI Individs, and that having learned from some of these people who were great snare drum soloists, that maybe I could do that too. Now, my priority had always been to play with quality and to play well in a line. And I think I did those things. But on this occasion, I really got myself into a bit of a quandary. As it turns out, I was woefully unprepared to put out a snare drum solo. Part of that was being freaked out that this would be the summation of everything I'd learned and could play, so that I froze and couldn't play anything. Being unprepared for this occasion where you were to be showcased, I played a snare drum solo that went 2 minutes over the time limit And Jeff Prosperi put great endurance on my sheet because I played flams for days. I was able to inject some of the things that I'd learned in that summer in Denver. But on this occasion, it's like putting together your senior thesis the night before it's due. I was writing and scribbling and teaching myself things in a locker room between the hours of 5 and 7 a.m. during finals week to try and put out a solo. And I was able to do it. I got 10th out of 30, I believe, with all the penalties and with none of the virtuosity in terms of flair and stick tricks and, you know, off your tongue and all these things that these guys are doing. I couldn't do any of that stuff, and I wasn't going to teach myself all that stuff in the number of days. Harkening back to the 91 12-8 feature that, you know, was such a flam jam that Mr. Thurston had written, Hanum came through and he had a rendition to play as well. It was very straight ahead, 16 bar feature, 12-8, let's go, fill in some spice, and it was a lot of fun to play. To see so many great lines and thousands of great young players putting out for us.
I'm going to be evaluating you in the area of performance analysis today. Physical, musical, rhythmic demand.
Drummers here, yeah, nice entrances. Okay, hand to hand. Wow, good for you. Crispy.
Juicy red meat, rudimental stuff that you really attack in a personal way. I feel like the players are really being trained to commit to the figures that they play.
I've taken the exact same approach to judging, which is of intense preparation and doing my very best, as I did as a player and as these players are doing for us now. And that's extremely rewarding, definitely the growth that you see in the groups, the great writing and instruction that players are receiving, and the great creativity and very engaged and very beefy books that we see now that I hadn't been asked to play when I was in high school, and that's all very exciting. I don't know if I have the hands that they do now. Of course, I would go to drum corps shows 4 hours away, and it would take up your whole day to drive, you know, out and back if there was a show nearby. Now you can just go online and see so many of these groups at the click of a mouse. My seat partner on the bus in 98 was a gentleman named Peter Salek, and he was a fine percussionist in his own right. He went to Rutgers and then on to North Texas and just came out with a book himself. He was gritted. Peter Salek was gritted. And those who were on the early internets and those who were visiting these different drumline sites and listening to the Ram tracks and you know, checking out the pictures and images of material that was up early on. I remember that Electric Wheelchair was an extremely popular piece and played by so many, but it was one of those that was available online early on. And University of Kentucky also had a pretty strong presence. So I would breeze around the internet pretty early on, and it was not the same internet as it is now. But knowing Gritted and having the access to that content and to those lessons that can be gleaned. Of course, you have to do it yourself. You can't just sit at the computer and maybe pad along with it. That's not attaining something. It's still that very simple formula that you see on all the billboards. You have to work hard and do your best and push yourself farther than you had previously imagined. And committing to that kind of hard work and obtaining, hopefully, the successes that can come of it, some very tasty fruit. Guess what, drummers? You're going to grow up one day. And, you know, drumming both in groups and rudimentally with your buddies at the coffee table offers some really strong, some fantastic lessons that you will have to take with you and hopefully employ in the right way later in your young adult lives, as I'm finding.